Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Farming Simulator 19. And what we're going to do today, guys and girls, is I've been asked if I wouldn't mind doing a skid steer comparison. Because one of the viewers of my channel asked me, would I test out the skid steers in various roles that you might use them for on your farm, and then see which one is the best one, or the one more suitable to farming applications. So we've got a couple here. We've got a couple of New Hollands, and we've got a couple of JCBs. So let's go through what we've got right here. Okay, this one is the most expensive one of all. This is the JCB325T Eco. It's got 54 kilowatts of power or 74 horsepower and costs $68,000. Next in line, we've got the JCB260. As you can see there, JCB260. This bad boy is basically the wheeled version of the 325. It has 54 kilowatts of power or 74 horsepower, costs $58,000. Then we jump down to the New Holland. Now this one is the New Holland C232. This one is basically 54 kilowatts of power or 74 horsepower. And it costs $49,000. And then we jump down here to the New Holland L218. This bad boy is only 45 kilowatts of power or 61 horsepower and costs you $35,000. It is the cheapest of the skid steers. Now, you might hear me accidentally call it a bobcat, because that's basically what I get. That's what I call them. They're basically bobcats to me. But they are skid steers because they steer by skidding either the left or right side of the vehicle. So it doesn't matter whether it's got wheels or tracks, it stops the two wheels to make it turn. So it basically turns on a dime. It's a zero turn, practically, vehicle. Now, we've got two attachments here. We've got a forklift attachment and we've got a bucket. Now, each one of these vehicles are going to be tested on three different types of loads, plus a cleanup duty back up at the farm. So in case you spill something, you want to know whether or not this has got the capability of picking up messes. So we've got a bit of spilled grass back up at the farm, so we're going to do that. So yeah, what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to pick up each one of these items and place it in the back of the lizard dual cab over here. And we're going to see which one, you know, lifts the more stably, handles the best, has the best visibility, all those sorts of really cool things that we need to know. Okay, so what we're going to do is we are going to start with the least expensive, which is the New Holland L218. Let's just jump on in. As you can see here, it's got a twin boom pickup system. As you can see, two arms lift up. Okay. Let's jump on the inside and have a look at that visibility. Now, as you can see, we've got a protective cage pretty much all the way around us. Nice glass window back there. So visibility out the back's pretty good, even though the exhaust is right there. It looks like we've got a seat belt. That's always cool to have. Okay, not much visibility above our heads though, but then again, we are protected. There's no protection for us in front, so if the load tips back onto us, we're in a world of trouble. And the gauges are pretty much non-existent. Okay, we've got our steering left and right. Looks like we've got a cup holder, a bit of ventilation, not bad. So there's ventilation. Maybe that's a door. Because I can't understand why you would have ventilation in an open door thing. So maybe that's a Perspex door. So we do have some protection. Ventilation, a cup holder, and looks like a place to stick your sandwiches or your chocolate bars, depending on what you've got. One arm operates the steering and movement of the vehicle. And the other one, by the looks of it, will operate our boom. All right, so let's start this bad boy up. All right, so visibility is pretty good. Let's have a look. Does it have any lights? We've got two lights above us. And no lights behind. Okay, Interesting, interesting, interesting. All right, let's pick up our forks. And let's pick up our first heavy load. Now, the first heavy load is going to be a bag that weighs 2,000 liters. Okay, so we're going to go up, raise our boom, and see if we can lift it without tipping. All right, here we go. Let's give it a go. We lift up. All right, bit of rocking there. But can lift the 2,000 liters, no problems at all. Take it over to our ute. Now, we have to lift over the side. The reason why we do this is because some farm trucks don't have a lowering tailgate. So we want to know, can we lift up and put in? And it looks like we just don't have enough reach to put it in over the back. Over the side. That's all right. Now we'll test it to see if we can put it into the back. Not a problem there. It's lowered down. I can back out. And it's there. So we're picking back up. So it doesn't have enough height to lift it over the side. Interesting, interesting, interesting. All right, let's lower it down. So it can pick up 2,000 liters, not a problem. We're going to pick up the hay bale next. Now this weighs 4,000 liters, so it's quite heavy. In we go. Pick it up. Little bit of rocking there. But that's understandable. It's a rather short wheelbase vehicle. Still pretty maneuverable. Oh, bit of forward tip there. Plenty of height to lift over the edge of the ute. No problems there. Let's drop it down. Oop, I've caught it on the back of the tray there. That's right, we'll fix it up. Alright, down we go. No problems whatsoever loading a hay bale into the back of a ute. Pick it up. Little bit of tip forward there. As you can see, it's rocking. So stability-wise with a 4,000 litre hay bale, not terribly inspiring. But it can do it. Down we go. All right, let's try the pallet. All right, in we go. For the final lift, check our visibility. With a pallet, as you can see, it does block your view. Okay, lifting it up. Going in, lowering it down. And I cannot tell whether or not I've got that in the ute or not. So visibility when lifting a load, not all that good. Can lift a pallet into the back of the ute, no problems at all. Bring it out. Well, there are problems when you're in first person. Okay, but it can lift it, no worries at all. Let's drop it down. She's a bit bouncy. Right, let's attach our bucket. And we're going to head up to the farm. All right, let's go. Now, this thing's actually quite quick. It does 18 kilometers an hour. That's not bad. Now, these things aren't designed to do trips between distances. They're basically designed to do very short trips between, say, where you want to clean something up or pick something up to where you want to drop it off. It is not designed to be a road vehicle. As you can see, there are no number plates. And at 18 kilometers an hour, it's pretty slow when you compare it to a tractor. Brakes are pretty good. Can't complain about the brakes. Now we're going to simulate doing a cleanup outside of an animal shelter, like your cow area, your sheep, or your pigs. And we're going to simulate cleaning up a mess. So what that will involve is us picking up some loose chaff, which is just over here. And we're going to see if we've got enough height to put it into the container just there. We don't have to actually dump it, but we just have to see if we've got enough clearance. So lower the bucket down. Picks it up, no problems at all. Alright, now let's see, do we have the height necessary to dump it in? Now, the answer is no. Not enough height to dump into the back of the trailer. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop that there. No, we're not. We're going to dump it. Okay, so unfortunately, the New Holland fails to be able to lift it into the back of the container. Let's road this thing back down to the shop and we'll jump into the next one. Having a few rendering issues here. I think it's from the smoke from the engine. Look at that. Brakes, they're not bad, but I suppose they slow it down gently to avoid you tipping it forward. But not bad. I mean, it is the cheapest one. Just going to cut across here, watch the bounce, see how badly we rock it around. Little bit of rear end lift there, not too bad. Alright, let's drop the bucket off. Alright, we're going to put this bad boy over here. And let's jump into the next one. The next one we're going to look at is the New Holland 232. Now remember, this one is basically $49,000. It's a tracked version of the 218 over there. So let's jump in. Once again, looks like it is a Perspex door. So let's just make sure that one's Perspex as well. It doesn't look like it. It looks like it's not really a door. It's a bit clear. Alright, so we've got a door on this one. I just had to make sure. Alright, let's jump on in. Let's have a look at the inside. Now, we've got a cage on the side. Cage over our roof, over our head. Interesting. Sliding door. View out the back isn't as good. We've got this huge big windscreen wiper stuck there in the road. Got a seat belt. Once again, some ventilation, a place to put your sandwiches. And it looks like we've got a bar that goes across the front of our chest to keep us in place. Okay, once again, one stick operates the controls of the skid steer and the other one operates our boom. So let's just start this up. Ooh, look at that. We've got a gauge there. Not very helpful, though. Alright. Let's have a look at the lighting. Ooh, we got more lighting on this one. We got two up the top. And two on the side. none out the back. All right. So let's once again, we will pick up our pallet forks. All right. Let's go see if we can pick up that 2,000 liter bag of seed and put it into the back of the truck. Once again, it's a twin boom system, so it's got two booms, one either side of the cab, that lift up. All right. Okay, let's back her up. We're going to test and see if we can load in over the side. Lift her up. Oh, lifted the truck up then. Look at that. We can lift in straight over the side. There we go. That's a pass for the New Holland 232. It can lift straight in over the side. I won't need to check if it can lift in over the back, because you can see right here, it can load straight on in. Beautiful. So that's really surprising. So even though it's a tracked version of the 260, it has more reach. See, how badly does it rock when we lift the hay bale? A little bit, but not as bad as the 260. It's a lot more stable. Loads into the back of the ute with the hay bale, no worries whatsoever. Easy done. Okay, dropping down our bale. Swapping to the inside as we pick up our pallet. Oop. Let's try that again. I can see the tines in front of me, which is good. But guiding those tines into the load, a little tricky. Lifting it up. I think the visibility is a little bit better here, but even with the pallet, it still blocks your view pretty badly. Okay, we're in and down. Slide on out if we wanted to. So that can lift the pallet into the back of the pickup. No worries whatsoever. And let's put it back down. Oh, I got stuck. Oh. Now, there's one thing I am noticing about this. Even though it has more horsepower, it's a lot slower. Pick up the bucket. And let's go for a road trip. It's an awful lot slower. Having tracks seems to slow you down quite a bit. Excuse the term, but I don't think it tracks straight either. I think it's a little bit more stable to drive than the 260, but it's a lot slower. A lot slower. Do not rely on one of these vehicles to do long distance trips. It just takes way too long. Brakes are good because it goes slow enough that you instantly stop. Alright, now let's simulate our mess cleanup. There's our mess in front of us. And we didn't pick it up. Still didn't pick it up. That time we did. Let's lift her up. We're at full height. I'm gonna have to zoom out because I can't see the top. Yep, if we were to dump that, that would go in. So that passes our mess cleanup test. Cool beans. So this one would be able to dump into a container if you needed it to do so. So that's pretty much full points for the New Holland 232. It can do cleanup duty. If you needed it to dump into a container, it could do that for you. Unfortunately, the 260 just didn't have the height. But this is incredibly slow. I'm starting to think if it would be quicker for me to put this in the front end loader and drive it down to the shop that way. Don't know if it'd fit. But there's a reason why they developed skid steer trailers. It's because this is incredibly slow. Now, I know some of you are going to say, well, why didn't you test it in a logging environment? These things we already know are really good at logging. They can have attachments to cut down trees. They can move logs with the correct log grabber. So they have no issues with doing things for logging. So yeah, any of these will be suitable for logging. The tracked ones are better at it because they're a little bit more stable. As you'll see as we drive over here, not as much rocking around as what we get with a wheeled version. Alrighty, so that's the New Holland 232. Groovy, nifty little tracked skid steer. In the true sense, it does skid. Has a few more lights, a slightly larger cabin. But you have to remember that this does cost $49,000, whereas this one only costs $35,000. All right, let's jump into the next one on the list, which is the 260 JCB Eco. Let's jump inside, have a good look. Full cage over our head, lots of protection. Really good. cup holder right next to the controls. That's handy. Safety handles, so if something goes wrong, we can just pop the whole thing out. That's cool. Let's see. Alright. I am noticing a lack of seatbelt. It does have a safety bar, which is probably substituting for the seatbelt. But I probably would prefer a seatbelt over the safety bar, because that's not going to prevent my shoulders from getting hurt if we do have a rollover. In the case that we do. Good to see some gauges up there at the top. That's nice to see. We've got an electronic park brake by the looks of it. You just push the park button. That's kind of cool. Looks like we've got some heating and ventilation. That's cool. Alright. Once again, one stick controls the movement. The other one controls our boom. And as you notice, this is a single arm boom, not a dual. So it has one arm on one side that lifts up and down. That can be good for visibility. So if you look out the side, only one issue. That blocks your vision pretty badly on that side. On this side, no problem at all. Rear window, no worries. Oh, look, fire extinguisher too. Cool. But it's a single boom, skid steer. So one arm to lift up and down. All right, let's have a look at the lighting system. We've got two there. And we've got two on the back. That's an improvement over the New Holland. So two at the front, two at the back. That's pretty cool. All right. Awesome. All right, let's start this thing off by going and pick up our forks. I like the offset exhaust too. It's off to the side of the vehicle. So that doesn't block your rearward visibility. If you have a look here. Clear out the back, no issues at all. Nothing blocking it. Alright, let's pick up the first one, which is our 2,000 litre bag. Oh, I missed. Have to try again. I'm too low. I'll have to try again. It's awkward doing this without the proper lifting equipment. There we go. No worries. I'm gonna lose it, aren't I? Nah. Alright. Come around to the side. Lift her up. And look at that, we got plenty of lift to go in right over the side of the truck. Or the ute, depending on what you want to call it. No problems there. Little bit of rocking. Little bit of instability. I feel it's the least stable, but I am lifting this in the upmost position. No worries. Loads it into the back just fine. Righto, let's pick up our hay bale. ...4,000 litre hay bale lifted up, no worries at all. Little bit of rocking. Not too bad. A lot less rocking than the New Holland 260. Load that back into the back of the pickup truck, no problems at all. Easy. Just bear in mind that this JCB 260 does cost $58,000. So it's almost a... It's almost $10,000 more expensive than the New Holland tracked vehicle. Okay, jump on the inside. Visibility, not all that great. The cages on the front might be good for safety, but for visibility, not all that good. Rear vision mirror works fine. Loads it into the back of the truck, no worries at all. It's a lot easier with this skid steer than it was with the other, with the New Hollands. It's a lot easier. That single arm boom does make it a little bit easier to load and unload. All right, we're going to dump off our forks. Pick up our bucket. Too easy. All right, let's road it up to the farm. Now, this is the fastest out of the ones we've tested so far at 20 kilometers an hour. That's not bad. That's not too bad. You know, 20 kilometers an hour is okay. You could use this for transporting between longer distances. We got a bit of flame happening out of that exhaust there. Look at that. Running a bit rich. Look at that. I got flameage. Interesting. Flames. It's a fire-breathing skid steer. That could be a hazard on your farm. Especially if you're using this to transport straw. A little bit bouncy. That's alright. Come up to our load. Put the bucket down. Drive forwards. Oh, I missed it. Yeah. There we go. Raise the bucket up. Lift up. Oh, lifted the container there. Righto. Zoom out. Oh, look at that. Plenty of height. If I was to dump that in there, it would dump cleanly. Look at that. That's a lot more than the New Holland 232. Dumped back on the ground. Cool. And let's head back. I think this goes quick enough for you not to use the skid steer trailer. 20 kilometers an hour, I know, is not, you know, land speed record breaking speed, but it's not bad. It's not bad at all. Brakes are good. Let's test the horn out. Yeah, that horn's cool. I didn't test the horn on the other ones because basically most of the farming simulator vehicles have really bad sounding horns. Most. Not all, but most. Little bit of rocking. Not too bad. All right, lower the bucket down. Detach, pull away. That's cool. All right, let's jump into our last skid steer. This is the JCB325T Forest Master. Now, there is an indication in the name of what this thing is really good at. Forest work. Let's jump into the cab and have a good look around. Okay, pretty similar to the one we just test drove. Pretty similar. Once again, fold down safety bar. I prefer a seat belt, but that's just me. Pretty good view out the back. Once again, fire extinguisher. Not bad. Good armrest on there, on the sides. Cup holder right next to the control there, but no place to store your chocolate bars or your sandwiches. Yeah, just remember that. No place to store your chocolate bars or your sandwiches. All right, let's fire it up. Jump on the outside. Let's have a look at the lighting. Okay, we've got four out the front and two out the back. Pretty cool. Once again, it's a single arm boom. All right, pick up our forks, go over to our bag. Oh, too low. Lift her up. Go in and, did I get it? Yeah, I did, but I don't think it's on a fork. So it's liable to fall off. That's staying on. Oh, come back. Lift her up. Plenty of height to lift it in over the side of the ute. No problems at all. Lower it into the deck. No worries. Oh, I dropped it into the back of the ute, but that's okay. We'll just have to go in and pick it back up again. I missed. There we go. Successfully recovered. Now, this has to be the most stable of the lot. Extremely stable. So if you had a lot of new people working on your farm, I would probably recommend this. It's stable. They're not going to tip loads so easy. But, once again, this is $68,000. That's a lot to pay for a skid steer. Loads hay bales into the back of the ute, not a problem whatsoever. Jump into first person view. Once again, visibility due to that cage, a little bit annoying. Lower our buckets down. Still too high. Perfect. Tip back. Let it slide onto the backrest. And let's bring it back. Let's raise it up so I can see where we're going. Okay, bring it down. Nice and level. Drive on in. puts it into the back of the pickup truck, no problems at all. Righto, let's pick up our bucket and head up to the farm. Righto, let's go. This is slow. I could not recommend this skid steer for doing medium distance journeys. It's just too slow. You really would need to load it up onto the back of a skid steer trailer and transport it between point A and point B. The wheeled version of this thing, JCB 260, I could, because that thing moves. Good thing about this one is there's lots of protection for the operator, but those cages do interfere with visibility. Once again, we got flames. It's not flames, people. It's just the reflection of the paint job on the exhaust smoke. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. It's not flames. If you didn't pick that up in the last video, skid steer that we drove, you would have realized it ain't flames. It's just a reflection of the paint. Righto, picked it up. That was pretty easy. Just dumped it all out. Not all of it, but a majority of it. Okay, picked it back up. Gonna have to zoom out one more time. Drive forward. And look at that, plenty of height. So both the JCBs get full points for being able to pick up our chaff. In fact, this time I am gonna dump it in there. 3, 2, 1, tip. Look at that, no problems whatsoever. Alrighty, guys and girls, let's take this back to the shop. And I'm going to give you my final opinion. The JCBs are a better skid steer. But they do come at a price premium. The JCBs have a lot more protection for the driver. That single arm boom system does allow you to have more visibility out to one side of the vehicle. So if you're working on a busy farm, you're not going to be trying to move the camera around to see who's right beside you. But do I think that going for this JCB tracked version at $68,000 is the one to go for? No. I don't. I, in all honesty, I can't recommend it. I really cannot. It's too much money. $68,000, that's a lot to pay for a skid steer. That is a lot of change. Do I think it's a great vehicle? Yeah, I think it's brilliant. But the price premium's a little bit much. Now, you also have to take into the fact that the prices I've given you today are not including the cost of any of the attachments. So you're going to be up for a couple more $1,000 for the forklift attachment, the bucket. And to be honest, to be brutally honest with you, I think for the money, I would have to say at $49,000, I think the New Holland C232 is the one to go for. It's stable. Okay, the twin boom system can block your visibility a little bit, but you know, it's reasonably priced, it's stable, and it does pretty much everything that the JCBs do, except save you a lot more money. So yeah, guys and girls, I'm gonna have to give it to the New Holland C232 in this episode. Post down in the comment section below, which one would you prefer? Do you prefer the JCB 325T? It's tracked, it's got good protection for the driver, single arm boom. Do you go the JCB 260? It's a wheeled version, and it's about $10,000 cheaper. Or would you go for the entry-level New Holland L218 at $35,000? It's the least powerful, but it's also the least expensive, and it will do pretty much what you would ask it to do, except for maybe dumping into a container. You might have a few height issues there, but there you go. Alrighty. Until next time, guys and girls, post down in the comment section below if you've got any other vehicles you want me to put into a Comparo, post down below. Alright, until next time, thank you all for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye for now.